gonna be the bass line, this gonna be the whatever. And I would go in the studio, and for him to sample it, I'd be sitting there for like literally 2 hours while he's trying to put it into the 950. And back then, my $50 an hour off the paper route really meant something. So I was like, yo, this is taking too long. So I wanted to move him out the way so I could figure out how to make the record. And it just kept going from there, going from there, going from there. It was me wanting to make records and figure out everything about sonics. That's just me. I'm an engineer by nature. If I wasn't a music engineer, I'd be a civil engineer or anything. I was the guy that like fix VCRs or like fix your mic or like whatever, anything that had a system or something that had to, I was the guy that like, I was in the hood and took pride in that. Like, I know how things work. That was my main thing. I wanted to be able to put together any record and work all the equipment. It was just like super interesting to me. That was it.
And then I think another question too for other people that want to do what you do and what Ali does is, the main question is, when do you know to start charging for your work? Like, when do you go from doing all the free sessions to knowing your worth?
The free session thing is difficult. It's like if you are building with somebody in a camp and you're saying, yo, this is Soundwave, Kendrick, and Ali together. We're building this thing to get somewhere. Then, yeah, you can do the free sessions. But as soon as you know what you're doing, you should be, you know what I mean? To me, you should be charging somebody if it's outside of your camp,
right?
If it's outside of your circle. Now, your circle, that's a different thing, right? You're building something together, but don't sell yourself short. Like, know your worth. As soon as you start doing that, and I'm not saying you gotta be charging hour rates, but if somebody can pay for the weed, they can pay for the
gas money.
Yeah.
But it's also like, you know, like my whole thing, like, I'm a hustler at heart, right here. Like, I would, like, I'm a hustler. Like, I was, like, back in the day, it was a company called SoundClick. Remember that? I used to steal Soundwave beats and sell them bitches for $25 on the internet. You know what I'm saying? Like,
that was the first time I'm hearing
that. And he reached out, so he's not tripping. But you feel me? Like, anything I did to get my issue, I had to eat. We was stealing hot dogs, we was thugging. But, like, one thing about myself that I even do to this day is the fact that, like, you know, the fact that we're engineers, we're at the bottom of the totem pole, right? You know what I'm saying? We're always used as pawns. People want to say we got a session here at this time, but they want to wait 2 days later to send you the files. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, everything is just a constant push and pull. Back in my day, I feel like what kind of got me going was the fact that my hustler ambition was like, nigga, like, you a bigger artist than I can ever imagine me working with. I'll mix your record for free. If you like it, let me get the whole album. If not, you can have this mix for free. You know what I'm saying? It's just being able to take a step back and take two forward. Never think that you're bigger than the actual goal, which is to create a common great project. But never be a bitch and never like let nobody take advantage of your work. You know what I'm saying? There's two different things of working for free to know that the outcome is going to be experience or opportunity, or working for free when the outcome is going to be a